Yep, new game segmented runs are possible. I mean, the Japanese can play Ikaruga, two players by themselves. They can do a Xenoblade speedrun. See ya. Yeah, doing a Xenoblade new game run, that's insane. Because you have to maintain your levels just right. You have to grind just enough to stay kind of within five levels of the enemies. Without grinding too much. I mean, I know there's a few tricks where you can push some of the enemies off, like really high leveled enemies. Off of a cliff, and they basically, you know, die as soon as they hit the ground, and then you get massive experience. But it's a very hard thing to do. And you can't stay too underleveled compared to the enemies, because otherwise it's just miss, 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 miss. Thank you. At least the game's being generous about giving me a clear feather for shot purchasing. Come on, you're totally dead. This fight's over. Wow! Yeah. I don't think I have enough. I think I'm only got like 260. Yep, no tech skip. I was trying to keep track of how much money I got through there, and I know I had like a couple of 100, you know, like a couple 60s in there, but I got somewhere between 2 and 300, but I think I was pretty close to like 260. Yeah, that was not a good split. Oh well. My big worry is later on anyway. Help me! tummy hurts. Oh, the poo bug. No! This run! Bum ba da da ba da da bum 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 bum. Don't you want to revive your petrified sweetheart? No, I want her to be a statue. I've taken her for granted. I do not apologize for that pun, by the way. A crane! The victim is a nun! She has no external wounds! Hey you! Don't touch the body! I'm not dead. I'm just laying on the floor in pain. Somebody call an ambulance. Hello? Anybody want to help me get up? You know, get some bandages, some ice, anything? I'm still lying here in the temple. Anybody? Thank you. gotten a lot better about how to get around that guy without needing to walk. Get rid of the pain you feel. Goodbye, pain. Time of danger. Out of my way. Thank you. NPC troll number one. Top on. We are the keys of the gates. They say like they're the keys to the gates when they're really kind of the representation of the gates themselves. Because wherever they are is where the gates are, not really the You know, if they were technically really the keys, it should be where they're standing should be where the open spots are. I don't know. I'm thinking about it too much. Alright. I'll love you, Gabe, if you give me a Spiral Claw. Please? Nope. No Spiral Claw. Favorite NPC? The ones that are dead. Frankly, they're all pretty worthless. That's kind of one of the nice things about the storyline. I can kill two of them. Yeah, it's too bad that the AI in them is not particularly good for, at least from a speedrunning perspective. They're not very helpful. They all have some very unique charm and personality to them, but from a speedrunning standpoint, I hate them. Claude! God damn. Didn't think it was possible for me to Claude that one yet. But then again, it did help that Draculark didn't start out with a spell. Say probably the best partners are probably Sierra in regards to AI and Lady Blackpearl for the synchro, which Lady Blackpearl synchro basically gives you a full ST meter, which basically means just you can just start spamming specials, which is flippin' awesome. Thank you. And probably my least favorite from a speedrunning perspective is Lark and Elazel. Those two are awful to have for a speedrun. Elazel likes to push him away, and Lark likes to do that too, but Elazel's worse about it. God, I managed another Glod? Really? Game, please, quit spoiling me this way. Yeah, Lazel's probably my least favorite. In regards, if you're talking strictly personality, I really don't like Lazel. He's kind of a jerk. I mean, especially in the way he treats Pearl. Out of my fucking NPCs. I mean, even Lark, who's frickin' working for the devil, isn't as much of a jerk as Elazel is. Damn, fucking enemy. I've never seen him use that many spells. This place is dangerous. You best be on your way. Thank you. This is the ferocious monster pout. Yeah, I already beat it. But whatever. I'll just take your advice, Watts. Oh, Watts, a small money and base helm, Watts protected with a base helm and a base helm, Watts, I started with a gate helm, Watts, you haven't really done that much. The end. Shut it, you! No story to tell. For the love of all that is good, game, please flippin' give me my Brave Blade drop. Preferably the first time. Yep, you made it back, DJ. Just in time for to see. Just in time for Troll Slitter and Lucre Blade. Fucking bats, please. Alright, here we go. Ring gods be kind. Fuck yeah! We have a run! Franker Z! In fact, I actually had both of them on that drop there. You don't get it, do you? What happened? We'll win the speed run. Isn't that right? We'll get world record. Shut up, yo. It's not a world record.
Huh? How come?
Because he's not the judge, right? I am judge and jury. And it ain't a world record until the fat lady sings.
Okay.
Isn't that right, Mr. Fuddy Duddy?
Okay. I'll take your word for it.
Okay.
Hey, cheater, you didn't find the world record, huh? I told you you're not gonna find it this way.
Check out this world record over here!
Okay. There's been people claiming false world records around here. Go earn one for yourself.
Let's work together for the world record!
I'm sorry, I'm very bored right now, obviously.
Let's run for the world record!
Yeah!
Come on. There we go.
Come on! Can't do a thing when we need to.
Rawr!
Yeah, let's go.
Thank you for helping us. Let's talk to the wolf guy.
And by the way, hi, Doysim. Yeah, it is leaving me a little weird. But it's a happy weird. -106. Salky, I'd like to meet you. Your hair looks so fabulous. Hey, Double D. Good to see you here. And my webcam's been disconnected for months. It's in a box somewhere. Though that picture of me in the upper right is just so swell. Don't I look awesome with that sword? Die! 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 The correct answer is spin. There we go. Fine. You're gonna be a jerk? I'll treat you like one. Jerk! Yeah, I've learned the ability to taunt. Hey, Dragon Dark, you suck! I'm a better Lament of Innocence player than you. Oh, that's not how it works? Yeah, I wish indeed. I will say it was fun racing against you at SGDQ 2012. Hey, at least I made it close until the end when the game decided to fuck me over. Well, partially that, and partially just me not being able to combo for shit. Yeah, I'm still waiting for pumpkin runs to show up on the site. Come on, man, get on it. I'm working on my game, you work on yours. Yeah. I don't know why the camera flipped around like that. That just totally pissed the shit out of me. Ugh. But, oh well. The sad thing is, that's the last time I've been to a GDQ, and probably the last time I ever will be. So I am planning on going to RPG Break 2015, though. Hey, Riga. You have too many projects. I happen to notice something on the... I also belong to Retro Achievements and been having fun with that. Apparently there's Crystallis achievements on there. And yes, I pronounced it Crystallis. Just because. Or I can pronounce it the other way, Crystallis. Since Uranium Anchor ain't here. Crystallis, 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 Crystallis. Sylvia? Well, shall we start the party? Let's start the party! Yeah, I don't really care which way it's pronounced. I should play it sometime for achievements, but... Come on, I was not on the carpet. Fucking game. That should make up for it. Damn! Nice that I hit with both hits from Shish Kebab. That just does so much damage. And that's why I use Shish Kebab for an attack. It's kind of the same reason why I like using Jawbreaker when I'm using gloves. In this game, for some reason, the level of the technique does not really matter that much. What ultimately matters is how many times it connects. Like, for instance, I was comparing Jawbreaker, which is a pretty low-level technique, against Erwin in comparison to Tiger Driver 91, which is a very high-power technique. And, yeah. Jawbreaker did more damage. Don't know why. Other than the fact that it connects multiple times, it's the only logical reason why it would do more damage. Which is why the one-handed sword triple tiger is flippin' awesome. I mean, pretty much like when I'm doing the Jumi storyline that I'm doing, and I use triple tiger against some Lord of Jewels 1000, if it connects, that boss is pretty much done in one hit. Well, technically three hits, but whatever. Thank you. And yeah, that boss totally got wrecked. Hitboxes, please. Level up, please. I hate when it always shows up at the end of the sequence like that, and I don't have far to move. Stupid enemies, please. Captain, you can't leave our stone mace behind. One more stupid joke and I'll have you clumped in your heads. Captain, that's not a threat. Say it like a real pirate. Fine. One more stupid joke and I will kill ye all! Yay, you are a pirate! You are a pirate! Forsake the link to see the sea! See? Kill ye all! Wait, the penguin started this! Ah! I shall go too. Good morals in this game. This mission teaches you that lying is awesome. And that penguins are stupid. Also, it's absolutely okay to do things without other people's permission. Like this. We'll be right back. boss dead. Yep, I'm gonna lose time on this split. That was a pretty cruddy boss fight. Oh well. Do as he tells! He doesn't reach the top of the cliff, penguins. Let's never go ashore again. Yeah, minus 24. Ugh. Yeah, there's definitely some aspects in this game that are, questionable for kids at best. Yay, we gained electricity! We have power! Death, murder, genocide, hell. Let's not forget betrayal. It. And if you consider the events of the manga canon, he also got, like, the way Toto treats the rabbi as emergency food. I mean, he got that. And then you also have the whole gender changing thing of Alex. And that, trying to explain that to kids is like, holy cow, good luck. Oh, we also forgot we have smoking in the game, too. At least the one... At least the one duck, you know, NPC version. It looks like he's smoking when you see him. Hey, Kirby. Boreal Hound time! I see how this fight goes. Kabob! You never know which way it's gonna go. The fuck, game. God damn it, game. Bye, Boreal Hound, you fucking son of a bitch. Yeah, Boreal Hound can absolutely wreck you very easily. Probably the worst wrecking I've ever had was I fought Boreal Hound. The area had max Jin level, and it was Jin Day. Yeah, boss got ramped up because of that. Because the boss is Jin powered. I mean, it's... Thank you. Considering how bad I got trolled, the fact I only lost 4 seconds, that's not bad. I mean, that was a pretty cruddy boss fight, and the fact that I only lost 4 seconds to that, that's a little comforting. Still plenty of places for this to go wrong, so keep pushing hard to the end. Glod! I don't know how I gained 1-1, except by splitting faster. Talking at the door. Yeah, don't attack me. I'm gonna join you later. We're gonna kill Diana together. I love you, Esked. At least the nice thing about Diana when you're fighting her is that she's very easy to counter-strike to death. The one bad thing about fighting her is that she likes to start her fights with the special technique around the world, which basically she runs off the screen one way and then runs back in from the other side like she ran her all the way around the world. Diana, faster than Sonic the Hedgehog. The keys to the gates. Oh, I didn't get trolled by that NPC too much today. Hey, Niccolo! Take me to the Tower of Winds. In a hurry. We'll be right back. And dead already. That's what I mean by Diana is so easy to counter-strike to death. Claude! The nun. Brooch of Love. Alright, we'll see how many of the Silver Skips I can get today. If I get them, great. If I don't, not that big of a deal. We'll be right back. Spiral Claw! Little late game, but I appreciate the thought. Alright, Selva Skip 1. Nope, didn't get it. It's not a big deal if I don't get either one. It's just kind of cool if I do get them. It saves a smidgen of time. Alright, Selva Skip 2. Nope, didn't get either one. Oh well. Thank you for trying. Please play again next time. Thank you. Alright, it's Irwin time. This is what the run really comes down to. Can I maintain the proper rhythm on Irwin? And the answer to that is fuck yeah! Hi Erwin, nice knowing you. Thank you for playing our game. Alright, cutscene play, let's meet Mettenberg. No, Matilda! Why did you have to die? Hey, Geno. Hey, Polygon. Good to see you both here. Don't know if you got to catch the Irwin fight, though. I've been consistent in getting Irwin down very easily. It's just a matter of getting that rhythm right. And if you get the rhythm right on Irwin, he's just absolutely screwed. I've actually managed to even get the rhythm right between the two attacks. Because normally you only have enough time to get one attack off between in regular tech and then when he goes back to do that fireball attack. I've even got pulled it off of there, too, so. soul can make anything you wish come true. I'm here because not only I wish for it, but so did you. And this unfair world you wish to destroy is about to end. Everything is created through us. Matilda, I will not embrace you, for your frail body would break if I did. Do not worry. We are no longer encaged in our earthly bodies. Damn, green. I'll take it. Couple missions to clean up, and we'll see how things go. See how many of them I hit. I can hit all four with shish kebab. It's pretty much just a matter of how they like to position themselves. Come on. Ah, three. The horse was too far back. He hopped away from me instead of toward me, which is why I missed him. Flan kitty. Meow meow. Pet Flan kitty. Purr purr purr. Kitty, warm kitty, little ball of fur, happy kippy kitty, sleepy kitty, purr, purr, purr. Think that's how it goes? Admittedly, I have not watched Big Bang Theory, so I'm familiar with it because of Big Bang Theory, but... And the dead bear didn't troll me with his positioning. Cool. Yeah, admittedly I just don't watch much TV because, you know, most of the stuff I'm finding on cable is to be kind of dumb. So I don't even have cable anymore. I got cable internet and that's the extent of, you know, I download anything I want to watch, which admittedly isn't much. I spend most of my time playing games. Heck, I used to watch a lot more anime than I do, and I don't even do that much anymore. The closest thing I watch to anime is Pokemon. Ooh, two channels! It's more than what I have. I have a grand total of zero. Well, unless you count the inputs as channels, then I have a few, but... Claude! Yeah, I'm not submitting anything to AGDQ because I'm just not planning on going to AGDQ probably ever again. They've just gotten too big for my taste and my comfort zone, really. I mean, it's great that
the event has gotten huge and has allowed it to raise so much money, but I like the smaller events. It just makes me feel just more comfortable in smaller crowds, so. I am stoked for Limit Break. I am planning on going to that. I probably will go even if I get nothing in there, but I doubt that all of my RPG games will be rejected. I've got plenty of good ideas, so. And I've already put my claim in on the Sentius dungeon for sleeping arrangements. Yeah, I forgot it's that soon. All right, let's see how many of these three I get. I got all three. Late hit on the third one, though. I'm surprised it actually connected. It's just because of the weird hitbox of some of these specials. Sword of Mana. All right, this is it. This is what it all comes down to. Do this.
3.14. Sanctuary's Gate. Home stretch. Let's do this. Just go, Bob, and all three. Corner three. Finish strong. Yes, come on! Yay for weird hitboxes. Yeah! Borderline 204-203. This is gonna be fucking close, because where I generally stop my splits is actually a few, apparently I figured out it's a few seconds after the game apparently does, so this is gonna be very borderline. It's gonna be a very low 204, a very high 203. Either way, this is a fucking awesome time. And that gold split to end it. Glad to end. Oh, this was the run, guys. This was the fucking run. Oh. RIP fairy storyline. Oh, this is going to be a nerve-wracking 10 minutes to find out whether this is a 4 or a 3. Oh, God. I'm just gonna sit here, shut up, and let you enjoy Song of Mono.